Well, school lunches, I think people tend to lump them all together, and they forget that the USDA reimbursable meals, so what we consider to be sort of the standard school lunch, has to meet the dietary guidelines for Americans. So there are limits on how much fat, how much sodium, you have to serve a certain amount of fruits and vegetables. Those meals tend to be the healthiest choices that most kids will have. The other choices, the a la carte choices, currently are not subject to any guidelines unless the school district sets those guidelines. So for instance, if there are actually school districts nationwide that serve name brand fast food, and those obviously don't adhere to the USDA guidelines. Even if it's not name brand fast food, if it's things like pizza, hamburgers and french fries, tacos, you don't know if they're actually meeting guidelines or not. So those foods are foods that I think parents need to ask for information. And there actually have been some studies that have been done in Minnesota and nationally that have actually looked at changing alternatives. So maybe they still have french fries, but they use baked french fries. Or maybe they still sell chips in the vending machine, but they use the low fat or the baked chips. And what they've actually found is that if you make smaller changes like that, so that you don't completely eliminate specific foods, but you go to maybe a healthier option, that schools generally do not lose the revenue that they think they will. Ideally, what we would really like to see is that parents model great behaviors at home as the children are growing up. So by the time they get to kindergarten or first grade, they're used to having a vegetable with a meal. They're used to drinking their milk with a meal. It really helps make the job of the school food service easier. The best thing that parents can do is actually work with their school district to advocate that all of their food choices meet either the IOM standards, and there are some standards that have been put out for all foods, whether they're a la carte or whether they're USDA approved, so that you know that whatever choice your child makes, it's going to fit within a recommended set of food items. And so I think to be sort of the gold standard would be to have every school district in Minnesota or across the nation actually have all of their foods, a la carte, vending, snacks, everything meet the IOM and the USDA guidelines.